Don't do these things when you have wet straight hair. Don't brush it. Wait until almost dry. No heat tools. You will fry your hair. No hairspray. Hair will get crusty.
How I grew my fine, slow growing hair, super fast. And went from this to this. Wow.
You're starting your curly hair journey, do not skip out on these three things, because had I known about it in the beginning of my journey, I could have avoided a lot of mistakes. Let's get into it. Stop avoiding the trims. And if you feel personally attacked, that was for you. You should be trimming your hair every 3 to 6 months. You need to cut off those dead ends. You need to cut off those ends that are weighing down your curls. Stop avoiding them. That was something that I was scared of because of length, but I promise you, when you trim your hair actually grows faster and healthier. When you're starting your journey, you're experimenting with all these products. You're trying to find out what your hair likes, what it does, and what it needs. And so product buildup is real. And product buildup is not something that you want to experience, because then moisture is not able to enter into your hair, okay? So what do you need to do? You need to clarify your hair at least 1 to 2 times a month. Find a good clarifying shampoo, but do not skip out on that, because one shampoo alone, like a regular one, is not enough to remove the buildup at the end of the month. You should be deep conditioning your hair at least once a week, at least. Especially if you're recovering from some sort of heat damage, chemical process, your hair is most likely lacking moisture. And what does deep conditioning do? It helps with moisture retention. It gives your hair the moisture that it needs. So if your hair is not where you want it to be and you're not deep conditioning, yo no quiero oír nada. I don't want to hear you complain.
Three essential hair care tips that I have followed for over 5 years, part two. I always shampoo my hair at least 2 times on wash day. I typically will have a pre-wash oil in my hair, so cleansing at least 2 times ensures a really clean scalp. And the focus is to cleanse the scalp, not my ends. Next, I always wear my hair in a protective hairstyle before bed, usually a braid, bonnet, or a silk ribbon, and always with a silk pillowcase. I never comb or brush my hair without putting product in it, usually an oil or sometimes a detangler. This prevents breakage and keeps my ends looking really full. I treat my hair like silk, so it looks like silk.
Long for C hair routine.
To go out for the result, nothing to discuss it, cause I did not buy you found them down, take it down, though. I'm a me, I be a dog, though. I don't feel that you're proud of me, that you're a dog, though. I'm a line that's your dog, though. I put my life into my job, and I know I'm in trouble. She manipulate my love.
After almost 3 years of learning how to take care of my wavy curly hair, I think I finally realized that the best styler to refresh these types of limp, lifeless curls is foams. And let me tell you why. First of all, I don't have to get my hair soaking wet as I would have to with a gel or a cream. It's enough for it to just be damp. Second, it's such a lightweight type of product that I don't have to be as careful with the amount that I use. I'm not saying that I gotta use the entire bottle every time I use it, but I don't have to be as worried that I'm gonna overdo it. Third, it doesn't require as much technique to apply and distribute as creams and gels tend to do. And last but certainly not least, the results always give. Yes, it always gives volume. It always gives definition. It always gives, I just washed my hair. Even though I didn't, that is the point. This is third day hair. And I can go up to four, fifth, sixth day hair sometimes, refreshing with foams, and it's always going to look fresh, voluminous and bouncy. So like, if you don't have a foam already in your routine, I don't know, go ahead and grab one. I have a whole YouTube video of my top 5 foams in the link in my bio. Bye.